Hey, I just got access to Adobe Firefly, so I'm super excited to be able to try it out. So for those of you who don't know yet, Adobe Firefly is in beta, and basically what it is, like Midjourney or Dall-e, is a text-to-image generator. As you can see here, we have some examples, some galleries, and the prompts behind them. But basically, the difference is that it's going to be integrated into your favorite apps like Photoshop, Illustrator, and so on. So let's take a closer look at this. So here is an overview. We're gonna look at what Firefly can do. As you can see here, we have a quick overview. We can just generate some images, bring them to Photoshop, clip them, and just continue working with them. So as you can see here, it starts with the prompt. You got four options, just like in Midjourney or Dall-e. And then the difference is that it all happens within your Adobe apps, so it's super convenient. We have some examples here of how it can be used, what type of images we can generate, all kind of art, paintings, illustrations, digital art. Ultimately, you're gonna be able to use it right here inside of Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator, and so on. But for now, it's just in beta, so it's a standalone app just to test it out. And I think this is super cool since I'm a branding expert and I work a lot on logo design and brand identity design. So it's gonna be amazing if we can just take some sketches and vectorize them, create variations, and then we have a fully editable vector of our sketch in no time, basically. So that's super exciting. And for those who work on videos, there are some new features where you are able to change the weather, change the mood, as you can see here, change the atmosphere, and of course change the colors and other settings. Here is some more preview for, you know, 3D elements and stuff like that. Now, before we start playing with these tools, I will show you how to get access to the beta version of Adobe Firefly, right? So basically, I recommend you to go and sign up, and it's gonna look just like this. Just request the access, fill out the form, sign up, because I was super impatient and it took about 3 days to get approval, you know, for me constantly checking out good times a day. So once you sign up, once you get approved, of course you're gonna have to accept these terms and conditions. Of course there are some limitations. You cannot create pornographic materials. We're not gonna do that. And there's a welcome to the beta. I just wanted to walk you through this because big difference between Adobe Firefly and other text to image generators like Midjourney or Dall-e is that they're more concerned about using other people's work. So as you can see, they trained this AI based on images from Adobe stock. And then the limitations are also that we cannot upload or export this video content. Also, we cannot just use it on our own artwork. We can just generate the artwork. Eventually, you're gonna be able to do it inside the Photoshop, Illustrator, and so on. And for now, we cannot use it for commercial purposes. Okay, so let's dive in and let's start playing with it, shall we? As you can see, here is a preview. You just input your prompt. Some images going to be generators. We can try out this text to image generator, which as I said, is like Midjourney or Dall-e. But what is new here, they have this text effects tool, and there is a lot of tools that are just coming soon. Here we have some gallery, and we have more tools coming soon that we cannot use yet, but it looks all super promising. You can try out this prompt right here, or you can start typing right here, which we're gonna do in a second. But something to note here is that if you hover over this, you can actually see the credentials. You know, it's gonna add this to your meta tag, to your file, before you are able to download this, that it's saying that this was generated with an AI tool. So I think that's pretty cool, and it's gonna give some credentials to, you know, if we use other people's work. Okay, so let's start generating some art. Since I love motorcycles, how about a motorcyclist riding a Harley through the streets of New York City on a sunny day? Hit enter, we wait a second. We have the prompt right there, and we have four options. And I really like them, especially this one. It looks almost as me, so I'm gonna give it a like. I'm gonna submit the feedback, but what's really interesting here is that we can change the aspect ratio of the image. So for now, it's just a square, 1:1. We can make it portrait, widescreen, and so on. Also, we have an option to convert it. So now it's art, we can make it a photo. And as you can see here, there are just realistic photographs. None, I guess this is just as a default, it's gonna be a photo. And then the graphic is gonna change the style for some more artistic style. Right here, we can also change the style. We have something like filters, we can play with that. What's really interesting is that it's gonna add these tags right here. So it's super easy and convenient to use because we have this great UI. We can do a lot of things here, but we don't have to like type in and change prompts just like in Midjourney, and we can just delete these tags and regenerate these images, and that should do the magic. So the prompt is still there and it's unchanged. We can change the themes. Let's make it pixel art and let's change it to art. And of course we can also change the technique. As you can see here, it's painting, pencil drawing, oil painting, palette knife. I really like this, so let's regenerate this. Let's see what happens. Combined two of these, which is weird. I guess it works. Now if you scroll more, we can also change the color and the tone. As you can see here, black and white. So we have all these filters. We can change the lighting, backlight, dramatic light, composition, close up. So there's a lot of convenient options right here in this sidebar, which I really like. Much better than Midjourney. As you can see, these are coming out pretty great. I actually love this one, so let's give it like again. Okay, so now let's go back and let's actually play with another tool that is available, which is text effects. And again, we can see a gallery of beautiful examples and the prompts behind them. As you can see here, black and gold dripping paint, peacock feather, really beautiful examples. Let's type in our prompt here. I'm just gonna say e-bag, and here we're gonna describe the effect that we want to fill in those characters, right? What kind of style do you want? So how about gold liquid drip? Just gonna hit enter. It's gonna take a few seconds and that's coming out really nicely. It's very realistic. As you can see here, again, we can switch the options. Do you want more gold? Do you want less gold? I think that looks fine. If we zoom in, you can see actual details. I think it's pretty nicely done. And again, here we can change, there are some sample effects. We can change it to flowers. Maybe we should do that to see more details and how it works. Some of these letters are better than the others. It actually kind of wraps it around the character, but we can change the fit. For now it's medium. We can make it super loose, which is gonna give you like more artistic feel to it. Maybe it's not perfect, but we can clean it up later in Photoshop. So for now I'm just gonna use it in medium mode. We can change the font, of course. I guess Cooper Black, some serif font would be much better for this purpose. Oh, that looks beautiful. As you can see here, you know, it nicely just wraps around, kind of distorts these flowers. Beautiful. I really love this. And again, you can change the color of the background. So how about I change it for something like blue, or maybe like light blue. That looks super cool. So I'm just gonna give it a like again. Think about how long would it take you to actually do something like that from scratch. You would have to find some stock photos and manually bring them into Photoshop and morph them. That would be really time consuming. I've done something like that back in art school. So now it just took me maybe less than a minute. And while it's not perfect, as you can see here, later on you'll be able to just continue working with that in Photoshop. So that's super exciting. And again, there is a lot of tools that are coming soon. I'm super pumped about. And here is some preview about that. But I advise you to just go and test it out yourself. Just sign up for the beta of Adobe Firefly and then let me know what you think in the comments below. Do you have some ideas of how you can potentially use some of these tools in your work as a graphic designer? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to sign up for the beta version of Adobe Firefly, because the sooner you apply, the sooner you're gonna get access. They are overwhelmed with all these applications. So just go ahead and do it right now. So that's it for today. Subscribe to my channel if you want more tips on branding, strategy, and design. This was Arek Dvorniczak from eBay Design. And I will see you in the next video.